of that control. And then we assign that to our local variables here. And we add, using the items.add function, we add and save a new record into our SharePoint request list, our parking request list. Now, one thing with the parking request, when it receives a new entry, it triggers a Microsoft Power Automate flow, which in turn notifies the appropriate personnel that a new request has been submitted. Let's go into the Microsoft Graph functions. We get the initiator first, the person who's opening up the form. We pass in the search user. We set this to either 0 or 1. Now, these comments are not correct. I need to correct that. This will be initiator, and this should be other employees. Or actually, let's do using the search feature. So this is for the initial user. We've got their SharePoint profile user ID, and we pass that to this function here. We call the graph using the PMPJS library function, graph auth service. Then once we receive response, we store those values into local variables, and then we determine, is this the initiator or is this an employee? If it's an initiator, we set the state of the initiator email, job title. This is just another way of setting state with the proper values. If we are using the search feature, then we would fall into this branch and we would set that state individually. That's why I set out multiple use state functions. But then again, we probably could reduce that. I'll have to look into it. If we have an error, we just reset all the state to blank. There's an additional check here for the CEO and founder. You could change this to whatever you want, because there is one, at least one top level employee who does not have a manager. They are their own manager, and that's the CEO and founder. So we determine if the job title matches that, or if it's blank or undefined. If either of these are true, we set the no manager state value to false. Now, this is a little bit backwards. False means show, which means we show this message and this yellow bar here. And we also clear out any values that are in this section here. If none of these are true, then we fall through and we set no manager to true, which hides this message and this bar. And then we make a call into our graph get users manager graph info, and we pass the employee, and we call a custom function that is inside of our utility graph service file. Let's go to the definition there. And we are using the Microsoft Graph client library to call to make a request to the user's endpoint and for the employee, and then the manager endpoint. We'll bring back the manager information. Let's go back to the request form. And then we set the state of our manager name, manager email, job title, and phone. And that is the parking request form in a nutshell. Now let's see what happens when we do a build and how to get our build over into SharePoint. Let me open up the editor and let's just do npm run build. If it looks like this is going to take a while, I'll pause the video and I will continue once it's done. We just finished building our code, and you'll see now we have a dist folder. This is from the webpack configuration. If we look inside of dist, we'll have a scripts folder, and we have renamed index.html to index.aspx. So now what I want to do, I'm going to reveal this in the Finder, and we are going to go over here to SharePoint. Let's end all these sessions here. Okay, let me go into scripts, I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of this one. And then let's open up Finder here. Let's go into our scripts and we'll just drag this over. And while that is uploading, we will replace our index.aspx. Let's make sure the scripts is loading. I'll pause the video so you don't have to watch all this. Now our file, our bundle file has uploaded and we can go back into our main folder. We've already replaced this file here. Relaunch the application. Give it a second and there we go. Now we're logging into the Microsoft Graph into Azure AD and we are good to go. And that is the parking request form. And I thank you for your time.